Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I would like to first of all apologize for coming late. There was one wedding that I promised to attend a long time ago, so I had to go to Albanian Islamic Center to attend. We welcome Mawlana Sheikh Hisham, our alim, our authority. And today something happened to me, probably not for no reason, and I will raise this issue in front of Mawlana Sheikh Hisham, see whether I said what I said, whether what it was right or wrong. I was khatib today in MEC in Morton Grove for the first Juma. They offered three Juma prayers, two for adults and one for the students. So I was scheduled for the first one, and I spoke about whom Allah loves. And quoted the ayah, you probably, all of you know about this ayat, and said that this is the ultimate answer from the Holy Quran. Who is loved by Allah? The one who follows the footsteps of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then what came to me, to my mind, to say during khutbah, I said, when I think about Isa alayhi salam, about the reasons why he is coming back, I have to think that he might be coming back because he knew about this verse and about this truth, that it might be that he asked Allah to be the follower of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam so that he can be loved in that way, so that he can fulfill the promise of this ayat. And after khutbah, we prayed two rakats, and then one Muslim stood up and said, what this khatib said, he is wrong. Isa alayhi salam is great enough that he doesn't need to be, that he doesn't need anyone. God praised him, made him great already. He is coming back, but we don't know why he is coming back, so please disregard what this khatib said.
It's good. It's good what that man said. Because this, to show, it's like a scale. To show how much you put a temperature when someone has fever, a thermometer, and it goes up to 40, 41, 42, what in the Fahrenheit, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105. They were awliya Allah checking his heart, how much his thermometer of anger is going up, or it is submitting. So that is, they know. What he said, that Sayyidina Isa is understanding that ayah and wants to be, to follow footsteps of Prophet, that I don't want to call him stupid.
person, if he read the hadith, when Sayyidina Isa asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to delay him to be from Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to honor him, to be from Ummatul Nabi, because of that Allah raised him. Or else he would have gone, like other prophets. But because he showed humility and humbleness to be from Ummatul Nabi, Allah delayed him to come back, to honor him, to be from Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because according to the ahadith, in some ahadith, not all of them, some of them they explain that كيف أنتم إذا نزل ابن مريم فيكم وإمامكم منكم. How is going to be when سيدنا عيسى will descend between you and your Imam من مهدي will be in front. سيدنا المهدي عليه السلام at that moment he back up for عيسى to lead the prayer. سيدنا عيسى refused. Say no, I asked to be from أمة النبي. You lead the prayer. I am from Ummatul Nabi. Let them go and educate themselves, these people, before they try to stand and criticize without knowing. Of course, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Follow Muhammad. And Sayyidina Isa is one of Bani Adam following Prophet. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in an authentic hadith, Adam wa man dunahu tahta liwa'i yawm al-qiyamah. Adam and who is under Adam are under my flag in the day of judgment. And it is very well established that all nations from Adam alayhi salam, from Nuh, Ibrahim, Sayyidina Musa, Sayyidina Isa, all of their nations will be coming to Prophet for Shafa'ah. How he is not being honored, cannot be honored by following the footsteps of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But unfortunately, there are people like that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. And what you said is correct, Sheikh. It is, yes, of course, it's, I don't want to say it, but it is, some people, they are rude. He was able to go between you and him and say to you, what you said is wrong. If he wants to be adab, has adab, but there is no adab. What you said is wrong, you show him the evidence and then it's finished. Those ignorant people, Imam Shafi'i, what he said? If 100 alims come to debating with me, I win on them. But if one ignorant come debating with me, he will win on me. Ignorant is ignorant, is not going to accept anything. These are people, Wahhabi, they are not going to accept whatever you are going to say. So, may Allah protect them, protect us and protect them and guide them back to what is good for them and good for the Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No problem, that's good test. Too many tests like that everywhere. Shoot, I hear any question? No question. So here it is, I was saying to the people here, it's not like a fuqh circle or a hadith circle. It is the teaching of the Maqam al-Ihsan, how to improve our behaviors and how to improve ourselves for moral excellence, for better behavior. this is what is important in Islam, in religion. Discipline, adab. At-tariqatu kulluha adabun. Your journey in your life must be full of diplomacy and respect. You cannot live with, to be rude with people. People will run away from you. Allah wants people to run to you. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he made his sahaba like stars because he taught them discipline. Ashabika al-nujum. My sahaba are like stars. بِأَيِّهِمْ اِهْتَدَيْتُمْ With anyone you follow, you will win. You will be guided. Any sahaba, you follow his way, his footsteps, you will be guided to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are the doors of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and guide the ummah. And opening soon for Imam Sanad, inshallah, for a masjid. And inshallah, Allah protect us, all of us. Thank you, Shaykh. I want to speak more. And what the other students said? They kept quiet?
Many came to apologize to me
for the rudeness
of what he did. And they said that he is known for that his father used to be on the board and that he used to do the same thing.
In Holy Quran, there are two boats mentioned, two ships. One of Sayyidina al-Khidr alayhi salam, one is Sayyidina Nuh. And the two ships has to sail for safety. Is not? One for its safety, to be safe, the one of Sayyidina al-Khidr, to be safe, he has to make a hole in it to sink. To be safe. The other one, to be safe, it has to be glued well, no holes. If there were holes, is going not to be safe. So the safety of Sayyidina Nuh's ship has to be no holes. The safety of Sayyidina Khidr's boat has to have holes. Why? Why? This one no holes, reaching destiny. This one with a hole, reaching destiny. Both safe. Sayyidina al-Khidr alayhi salam showing us Sayyidina al-Khidr alayhi salam, he put the hole in the ship, drilling it in order because at the end there is a tyrant, Jababira. يأخذ كل سفينة غصبة. There was a king that takes every ship by force. So that ship, if it was going to go all the way there, full of dunya treasures, the tyrant is waiting to take. So you have to have a hole in order that it sink. Please don't sail with your dunya ego. He put a hole in the ego of the self. The self is Ibarra, example of a ship. We put the hole in it, means killing the self. He put a hole, he is preparing Sayyidina Musa to accept that you have to step your ego in order to learn. Because there is a shaitan at the end. If he sees you normal, he's going to take you. If he sees you already stepping yourself against his will, leaving you. You'll be safe from Iblis. When you put that knife in yourself, what he did after? He killed the boy. Means he killed that completely was able, Sayyidina al-Khidr at that time, to kill the ego, the complete ego of yourself, after preparing Sayyidina Musa for these different levels. We'll explain them tomorrow, inshallah, in detail. But for Sayyidina Nuh, they submitted to Allah's will. Everyone on that boat was submitting to Allah's will, and Bismillah marsaha wa majraha. In the name of Allah is going to stop and to move. So it is submitting to Allah's flood, to Allah's will, wherever it takes it. So it has to be hold together. If any hole hits, it will sink. So it's safety with its submission. The other one, it's safety with stepping the ego. So people today are like that. They are two different kinds. One kind following his ego, one time trying to glue the mistakes of the others. May Allah glue our mistakes and take them away. Hurmat al-Habib, Hurmat al-Fatiha. Ali? Sure. If they want. Ask them.
Would you like to...
They are not here.